There is an undeniable power in a river. A power that manifests in a simple flick of a switch. But the question is, how does that power get there? For Tulsa District, that involves our 8 hydroelectric power plants. In the most basic sense, hydropower is an energy conversion process. The potential energy in water is converted to kinetic energy by turning a turbine, which converts to electrical energy in a generator. To give you a sense of the amount of that energy, a cubic foot of water at 70 degrees Fahrenheit weighs a little more than 62 pounds. If 7,400 cubic feet per second of water is being released by hydropower, that works out to about 230 tons of water per second turning the unit's turbines. Even with that amount of energy, Tulsa District hydropower is not normally a primary source of power.
Tulsa District hydropower is approximately 600 megawatts capacity. The load requirement for the area we serve is much greater than that. But what hydropower does for the system is help balance the generation load equation.
The electric grid is like a seesaw. On one side you have electrical generation, and on the other load, or how much electricity is being used. The two sides have to be equal or you risk consequences like a blackout. During peak load periods, when coal-fired power plants can't react quickly enough to match a rise in load, hydropower plants can come online quickly and make up the difference in generation to keep the balance.
So that our relatively small amount of generation helps stabilize the system and gives high value to the electric power system.
Hydropower releases are also dictated by other factors. For instance, during high water events, hydropower, if it is available, is the first option for water release from the flood control pool. Through it all, the hydropower mission of Tulsa District is to make electrical power available safely, efficiently, and reliably to make sure you have the electricity you need. To learn more about hydropower and other missions of Tulsa District, go to www.swt.usace.army.mil and click on the Missions drop-down menu.